Before that, I was an editor of Project Computer, so I was the one who agreed to hire the first one of the first investigative reporters of politics. I'm going to move off the job. I remember when I was graduating college, and I decided I was like, well, there's something
reason that I wanted to be in journalism. And if you have to do something, you would say, like, oh, it's my career, you know, it's time, and just use that number. You know, they'll never make any money with all those things. And sometimes those things are good, but I think women can do pretty well as well as that. Probably because people like you guys have seen the way for us, probably because the industry is changing a lot. There's a lot of companies where I do opportunities. I'm
I think for human carbon from the next generation, they're going to have to, by some of the change, they're going to have to get new ways of distributing the waste. And I don't think that the first ones are to do really work on digital and including that in the real times. Waste and living community has for a lot of people to kind of watch us online, but even in the last
ways to respond after this all, and it's possible to and that might be a limited issue, or I think it broadly as well. How do you hear all these things? We think our audience is more women than men. We think women, our motto is very much, we do have a website like that, but our motto is very much, you know, distribution via social, and sharing people, you know, to read a story and they want to share it with a friend, share it with a
coverage,
how people may come back to that. Okay, that was a really powerful experience. But the blame is there, right? A lot of people are going to get this stuff, not just me. I found it interesting when the story began to unravel. The Washington Post was saying, you know, you did a good job and you reported for them, so I'm sorry. But as somebody makes me out, I was like, I wrote this story to House attorneys. You were it was just seems to me like there's so many. So many times where either the editor failed the reporter or the institution failed the editorial process. And I just was kind of surprised by that. You were being called a major advisory letter where you send somebody who's accused of a serious thing that you're going to write about a letter detailing things that you're going to write about. And they get to respond, and you may be clear, that's not, you're not going to change, necessarily change what you're saying, but these are detailed things that you're going to say, you know, respond to. Like, do you have a comment about something? It's easy to kind of just pile on a little token. I think that, in addition to just reporting violence, I was that. When they first kind of were called out of their first class was to break this work. The problem and put all the data on her, and I was trying to say, Columbia report was basically like, this is not this woman's fault, like, you failed to prove this woman was not being held responsible, which is fine. But yeah, I think so. To some people, this will make it harder for the reporters to do journalism, but it couldn't make good journalism. I'm not able to do their job specifically. Yeah, I think it's fine to get all of these creative work part of the of 17-year-old,
are doing great. And you said, I know that. You said, but I don't have a little sister, and she can tell you that. And she can be able to see. She will do it the best I can. And I'm hoping somebody else can. And I only can do it.
I think I could reject that. far down to this town in Alabama. It was the first time she ever really did a tour like this. She ended up building a relationship via social media messaging. So it was really cool. It was a girl. And it was like, not a lot of people really had a chance to talk to somebody who was still inexperienced, still very much a part of it. And she was able to talk to young woman's family, to the little father. And it was a lot of negotiating with honor and making sure that we, were further thinking about what we would not do for this. A lot of us who change all sorts of names and do all sorts of stuff that we just feel comfortable with. And I spent a lot of time on the phone with him. And then I was joking that I was going to have a lot of text message from him and just checking in on stuff. And the end result was that she did this great story that got a lot of attention, that I was happy with, that our readers were happy with for the most part. And a couple of days later, the father said, Ellie and I have a chance to say that he was so grateful, that he was so sensitive to his family and that he received a lot of support. He was terrified that he was going to come after the research work. We actually received a lot of support, and I think a visibility to check out how the story was actually sort of liberating for him. But it was just an interesting story about how two young reporters develop and figure out the moment and do what ultimately is like a career changing story. So that was really. It's super important to get everybody in the field who wants to be a journalist and develop their skills and who want to be editors. Groom them for managing leadership goals. I think that's really important. But I think that if you kind of change the minds of the co-workers, it becomes a byproduct of the first one. And you can hope that if you're building a team of really smart, brave women, you're also building a team of really smart, open-minded women.
We thank Jill for being a wonderful scholar of residence and for being a professor. Thank you and good night.